Is your period trying to tell you something very important? From bright red to dark brown, even pink or orange, or sometimes a period blood poop. Every color has a story. Today, we're explaining period blood colors and busting all the myths around it. We'll also be revealing to you what the color of your period could be telling you about your health, plus the real signs you need to pay attention to. So, from the very second of this video to the very last second, it has exactly something to tell you. So don't miss anything. Let's dive in. Hey everyone, welcome back to Good Life Diary on YouTube. If you're new here, we make women's health very easy to understand, from reproductive health to fertility tips. Please do subscribe and turn on the notification bell and we'll get started. So first, let's talk about why period blood isn't always bright red. You know, period blood isn't just ordinary blood. It's a combination of blood, uterine tissues, and mucus. And depending on how quickly it leaves your body, it can vary from bright red to even brown. So let's break down what these colors could mean for you. Firstly, the bright red color. Your period blood is bright red typically in the heaviest days, that is between the first, second, or sometimes the third day of your period. That is when you expect a bright red color. And the brown color simply means older blood that is taking longer to leave your body, and this usually happens towards the ending days of your period. And they are not exactly black, they are just fresh blood that became oxidized into darker colors. If you're able to smear it against your finger, you will see the hidden redness indicating that it was previously red, just that it became oxidized and is now looking like it's brown in color. And then the pinkish kind of period blood. This usually happens maybe during the first days of your period or maybe in the ending days of your period. But if you're consistently getting a pinkish period blood, this could mean that you have low estrogen or maybe another sign of hormonal imbalance or something. So you may need to see your doctor for this. And then the orange or the gray color of period blood. This is completely not normal at all and indicates the presence of an infection. So you need to see your doctor. So growing up, there are a lot of things we are told about period blood that is not true. So right here and now, I am busting some of those myths so you know exactly what is false. All right. So number one is, watery period blood is due to anemia. No. Period blood that is watery is simply due to cervical fluid dilution and it is not due to anemia. The second myth I'm busting today is that period blood is dirty. Period blood is not dirty. Okay. Period is not a means of flushing toxins away from the body. No, that is not a means by which the body gets rid of toxins. It is actually a mix of your uterine tissue, a mix of mucus, and then some amount of blood. Though this blood is very different from the blood that flows through your vein. Remember, that one is sterile and does not contain anything at all. The only thing it contains are the various components of blood. That is how it's supposed to be found in blood. All right. But this period blood is not dirty at all. Remember, I've already talked about you getting to get some amount of your period blood and trying to smear it against your finger to better appreciate it, to know this is brown color. Let me actually know what it is. Is there anything inside it? You can actually do that. It came out from you. Know that period blood is not dirty and it shouldn't stop you from having sex during your period if you want to, if you feel like. After all, I've said in my previous video that some people ovulate during their period, though it applies to people that have a shorter cycle length. All right, so there's absolutely nothing dirty about period blood. It is your blood, it came out of you. I have a detailed video in this channel where I discuss the easiest method to calculate your ovulation. There, I explained very well the class of women that could ovulate during their period. So if you're in doubt, you're not very sure when you ovulate, you might want to see that video. It could provide further guide for you. All right. So another myth is that clots in your period is dangerous. No, getting some small amounts of clots in your period, typically during the heavy days, is normal. However, if you do get larger clots and they are more in number accompanied with heavy period, this could be a sign of fibroid and you may need to speak with your doctor so that he will assess you and be able to tell you that this is normal or it is trying to tell you about an underlying condition. Another myth that I want to bust today is that your period must be exactly 28 days. No, that 28 days is just an average number. That's a lot of women have been assessed and they've been found that a lot of women tend to have a 28 days menstrual cycle. Doesn't mean that every woman has a 28 days menstrual cycle. No, any menstrual cycle length between the 21 days to 35 days is normal. What just matters for you is regularity. If your period is 22 days, let it be regular, plus or minus 2 days is fine. If it's 25 days, let it be regular. If it's 30 days, let it be regular. What matters right here is regularity and not round the clock. Though some is round the clock, but if it is not, it is also very normal. But if your period is less than 21 days, or just maybe it comes to 21 this month, next time it's 35, next time it's 14, sometimes you miss it, that is when you begin to raise your eyebrows. But if your period is 30 days, for example, any changes of plus or minus 2 days is fine. It's fine, it's in line. What matters is regularity and not just the round the clock of a thing. All right. So, I already mentioned that your period blood could give you clues about your health. So, what are some of those things your period blood could be telling you about your health? Number one is you're experiencing very heavy period. This could be a sign of fibroid or a sign of hormonal imbalance or maybe a sign of thyroid disorder. All right, so you need to speak with your doctor. He's going to tell you to do an abdominal pelvic scan and he'll also tell you to run a hormonal profile test. This abdominal pelvic scan is going to rule out the presence of fibroid, all right, and then your hormone profile, typically done around the day 2 of your menstrual cycle, is going to assess your hormones in general, from prolactin to estrogen to progesterone and to other ones. There this any variation or deviation from how they're supposed to be could make you to experience heavy period. All right, another one is very light menstrual period. When your period is too light, it could be a sign of stress. You've stressed yourself so much within that month and the resultant effect is a light period. A very light period could also be a sign of a hormonal imbalance. It could be a sign of PCOS, which is one of the very significant causes of infertility, though it's very, very treatable, right? There's no cause for alarm. The prognosis is quite high, all right? It could be a sign. So very light period could be a sign of PCOS, could be a sign of stress. It could be a sign of severe weight loss. You just lost so much weight all of a sudden. It could tell on your menstrual period, all right? So another one is you're getting grayish kind of period blood, or your period blood is orange in color, or it has a foul smell. No, period blood can vary from bright red to sometimes pink during the early days, and maybe sometimes dark brown, that is showing older blood. But your period blood can never be orange, it can never be gray. When you see it, is a sign of a bacterial infection. Gray is discharge. I've talked about this in some of my videos. I will link some of them in the description box. Grayish form of discharge is a sign of bacterial infection, usually bacterial vaginosis. All right. So if you get these colors of period blood, orange, gray, or is the period has an odor, a bad odor, fishy or foul smelling, either of it, it could be a sign of bacterial vaginosis or the sign of a sexually transmitted infection. So you need to speak with your doctor so you start on time. Another sign is very painful periods. Yes, while it is normal for you to experience some slight crampings, lower abdominal crampings during your period, it is also totally abnormal for you to experience period pains or period cramps that makes you to cancel out all your day's activities. They keep you in bed, you can't even do any other thing. The pains are so severe. It is not normal at all. It could be indicating an underlying medical condition. So you need to speak with your doctor early so he will rule it out or you start treatment in line with that. Okay, so overall, any sudden changes in your menstrual period, your period suddenly becomes super heavy, becomes super light, or it becomes super painful, it is not something you need to ignore. You need to start on time, speak with your doctor about it so that you can get the appropriate kind of help you need. So, in conclusion, your period is like your feminine monthly report card, okay? And paying attention to it could tell you so much about your health. And we've come to the end of this video, okay? Please, if you found any value, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on that bell for more informative, science-backed up women's and fertility tips, okay? And if you've got any question, drop them in the comment section and I will attend to it. All right, I'll see you in my next video. Thank you for watching. Bye.
So this is more like a behind the scene footage. After making this video, I had to prepare some of these colors. I especially sorted them out from the market so that I can illustrate most of these things for you. This is the gray color I talked about, the pink, and others. They are not real blood. I mean, I had to make them so that I can illustrate my video effectively. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.